PKanalix can be used for efficient non-compartmental and compartmental analysis. The computed parameters are given as tables and as automatically generated plots. In this video, we will see how the plots help to easily interpret in a graphical way the results of NCA. In this example, I have loaded a dataset with PK data that I can easily visualize in the tab Plots in the Data Viewer. This data corresponds to oral administrations of single doses with two different formulations that I can distinguish in Stratify with the covariate form. I can, for example, color by form, and I see clear differences in the absorption phase between both formulations. I have chosen some settings for the NCA calculation, and I have checked in the tab Check Lambda Z that the estimation of Lambda Z by regression seems fine for all individuals. This step is shown in details in the feature of the week video number 54. After running the NCA, I can see the tables of PK parameters in results, but I can also visualize the results in a graphical way in plots. The first plot shows the distributions of all PK parameters computed on the data on different pages that I can browse on the top of the page. In display, I can choose to have the distribution displayed as cumulative distribution functions instead of bar plots, which can make it easier to see different values found for T-lag, for example. The second plot shows scatter plots of all pairs of PK parameters. Since many parameters are computed, only the first six parameters are displayed by default. And I can modify this selection in display by picking the first parameter I would like to see, for example, AUC infpred, and holding the Ctrl key on my keyboard while I click on other parameters, for example, Cmax and Tlag. In addition to the dots representing parameter values, a linear regression slope is displayed, and I can overlay the correlation coefficients by clicking on Information. This plot is convenient to check for expected or unexpected correlations between parameters, or to identify outliers in the dataset. For example, I can have a closer look at this dot that corresponds to large values for Cmax and Tlag. Like in Monolix, the plots are interactive, thus hovering on the dot shows the corresponding ID, and clicking on it colors this ID in all the plots, for example also in the Data Viewer. I can then easily check that there seems to be no issue with the data for this individual. Finally, the third plot shows the relationships between the computed PK parameters and the covariates in the dataset, as scatter plots for continuous covariates, such as age, height, and weight, or Xbox plots for categorical covariates, such as the formulation here. Here again, I can choose a list of parameters I want to focus on, as well as some covariates. I will choose to focus on the distributions of AUC infpred, Cmax, and Tmax in both formulations. With this button, I can choose a horizontal layout to see better the box plots. In this case, I see clearly that although the AUC to infinity is similar in both formulations, the distributions for Cmax and Tmax are quite different. Of course, like in Monolix, these plots can be exported as images in the results folder, one by one with the button on top of the page, or all at once with export and export plot. In order to make the most of these diagnostic plots, it is recommended to tag as covariates all columns in the dataset that can be useful for stratification. In this last example, I have tagged the dose amount as a categorical covariate in the dataset, and I show on this plot the volume of distribution with respect to the dose. I see that there seems to be a dependency between the two, which could indicate non-linearity in the PK. That's it for this video. Have a nice week!